the word you hear that cleanses your mind. When your mind has been cleansed, your life is holy. If you are not taught who Christ is, you cannot live an effective Christian life. There is no other honor greater than that of sonship. Worldliness is the trap that enslaves men to the devil.
Relationship with God is a gift. Fellowship is a choice. The true expression of divine love is forgiveness to others. What you pursue is an expression of what you desire. Chapter 9, verse 36. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion on them because they were, number one, confused. Number two, helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Lift your hands and thank the Lord. I'm talking on the relevance of a shepherd. Hallelujah. He says, when the Lord saw the crowd, there is something he realized. The people were confused and they were helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. I said this to you as an opening statement. God is not a man, but God has ordained in his wisdom to manifest himself to men only through a man. Which means they were helpless, not like people without a God, but like people without a shepherd. So even though they had God, their experience of God was truncated and hindered because a shepherd was absent. Are you following me, child of God? So the issue of the earth now, why people are confused and helpless, is not because God is absent. It's because shepherds are absent. Are you with me, dear child of God? So there is a need for us to grow and understand the relevance of shepherds. The relevance of shepherds. Therefore, it is the ministry of a shepherd that ushers men into the experience of the blessings of God. When a shepherd is absent, you will not experience God. He saw the people that they were confused and helpless. He didn't say, oh, there is no God. He said, ah, these people have no shepherd. Every time God realizes that men are stranded, he answers their prayers for help by sending them a shepherd. I'd like you to understand this so that when you see a shepherd, you understand what he represents to heaven and earth. When God realizes that men are stranded, he answers their prayers by sending them a shepherd. Many people do not understand this. That is why they have no importance, no value. They don't understand what this man came to do. The Bible says, the Bible gave an account. It says, and the Lord was walking with the disciples and said, who do men say I am? And he asked them, who do you say I am? Why was it important for him to know what they thought about him? This is because the value you place on a man depends on your understanding of his relevance to your destiny. People don't value things which they think are not relevant. So if you don't know the relevance of a shepherd will come your way and you will treat him anyhow, and you will miss what he carried for you. Nations cry. God says, I'm sending a shepherd. You must understand how important this is. The people were confused and helpless, and God said, they have no shepherd. In the next verse, he says, pray the Father that he may send laborers. Look at what he's saying. So people were sick. People were poor. People were afflicted. He says, listen, you people should pray that God should send you a man. I don't know if you are following me here. So God is saying that whenever men are stranded, he recommends they should pray to him to send them a man. Not to pray to him to help them, to pray to him to send a man. Because the reason why they are in the state of helplessness is because the ministry of a shepherd is absent in their destiny. Follow me very well. He saw them that they were confused and helpless, and he gave them an advice. Verse 37 says, he said, pray the Father that he should send laborers. I thought you would say, oh, you are helpless. Pray God to help you. He said, no. Your problem is that you don't have a man. You don't have a shepherd. You don't have a leader. You don't have a man whom you follow. You don't have a man that walks with God and has seen what God's plan for your life is. So you are stranded. No matter how anointed you are, the fulfillment of your destiny depends on the way you relate to the shepherd of your life. No matter what God told you, no matter how he appeared to you, there must be a man. In the absence of a shepherd, there are two things we saw. Number one, when shepherds are absent, men are confused. There was confusion. Confusion means lack of direction. They were confused. They don't know what to do. They don't know where to go. Now, this is my problem. You may still have the Holy Spirit. Never forget this, that the purpose of the Holy Spirit in the life of the ministry of the Holy Spirit is not intended by God to replace the ministry of a shepherd. They are working together. There are some things that God has to do through the Holy Spirit, and there are other things he has to do through a shepherd. Are you with me? So we realize that when shepherds are absent, the first thing is that people are confused. Every time you are in confusion, it is a sign that either you don't have a shepherd or you are not properly connected to his ministry. Because the major assignment of a shepherd is to give direction to the sheep. They were confused. That is why we must pray against pride. Pride is dangerous. Pride is what makes you think that you can guide your life by yourself. No. You need a person. Sir, I want to travel. There are 3 countries. Where should I go? That is why you can never enjoy the power of the ministry of your shepherd if you don't wholeheartedly trust in him. Because you are asking me, sir, this man wants to marry me. Should I accept? What if I say no? Will you not be angry with me? So you cannot truly relate to a shepherd when you don't fully trust him. You must understand that now in my life, this man is the one that is giving me direction. I accept what he says. They were like sheep that were, I hear me very well. The greatest reason why people don't fulfill destiny is because they are attacked by the spirit of confusion. They don't know what to do. They are confused. Trouble in their marriage, they are confused. Listen to me. You see something? You may read the Bible as you like, but unto a shepherd, there is a gifted wisdom. People of my age, when I'm talking and they talk, there is a very big difference. You know why? Because me, I am a shepherd. God has to give me a wisdom so I can lead even my age mates. I don't know if you're hearing me here. That is why when the devil wants to hinder a Christian from enjoying the ministry of his shepherd, it makes him offended with him. You cannot be arguing a man whom God has sent to stop confusion in your life. You must accept, I don't know better than him. Even if you think you can quote more scripture, there is a wisdom in him from above. If he has no wisdom, he cannot be your shepherd. And this wisdom is demonstrated in the mighty works he does. They said, Jesus, what wisdom is this that these mighty works are done? Wisdom is not in grammar. Wisdom is the fruit of wisdom is the mighty works done by the person that has it. So you can't be arguing the person, because his assignment is to remove confusion. He will just move to you and say, hey, resign from your school, start selling dresses. No, I have my own plan for my life. That is what is killing you. You have not learned the power of humility. You have not learned the relevance of submission, of saying, sir, I accept, because you are my shepherd. He said, the sheep hear his voice and they follow him. When he calls them, they don't argue, they follow him. If I come and say, hey, all of us, we are fasting 2 days, I saw evil birds coming. Don't say, me, I plan to fast by next week. No, follow what the shepherd is saying. He who is ahead sees farther than you. He sees further than you. He sees what you are not seeing. His assignment is to eradicate. There are people that come to my office for issues, and I tell them something to do, and they don't do. And I will just feel bad because they don't know what they are doing to themselves. I want to ask you, who is your shepherd? I didn't say who is your pastor. Prophet Kevin, you can see Prophet Kevin as your pastor, but am I your shepherd? Pastor is because you worship, you fellowship here. Shepherd means you have submitted your life to my counsel and instruction. That's it. A shepherd is a man whom you have agreed to submit your life to his counsel and instruction. I can be your pastor. I preach, you write notes, but I'm not your shepherd because I'm only your shepherd when you are walking by my instructions and counsel. If my counsel is not important to you, I am just a pastor whom preach and you write not. I am not your shepherd. A shepherd has power of decision over your life. Are you following me here? A shepherd. Peter was a fisherman. The Lord came and said, follow me. Do you know what it means to ask a married man and say, leave your business and follow me? And don't forget that the Lord Jesus was a child to Peter. The Lord Jesus came to him at when he was about 30 years old. And Peter was about 45 or 50. Peter was more than him with 20 years. And a boy, a stranger, come and say, follow me. Then Peter must be seen in the spirit. Say, I'm following you, sir. That's what it means, a shepherd. A man for whom you can abandon your own plan to agree with what he's saying. Because somehow you know, even though you don't understand what he's saying, you trust in the wisdom of God in him. Sir, I will do what you have said. Nothing moves the hand of God on the head of a sheep like his obedience to the instruction of the shepherd. Stop playing with your destiny. You must have that man or woman that when he speaks, you tremble. When he speaks, you stand. Do this. Yes, sir. There is a spirit of pride moving around. A spirit of stubbornness, disobedience. That is why he said the people were scattered. They were confused. Their life had no direction because they have not submitted to the ministry of the shepherd. Number two, he said the people were helpless. So, when a shepherd is absent, what is the first thing that happened? Confusion. Number two, helplessness. In Matthew chapter 24, verse 44 to 45, the Bible says, whom his master, Agabanasi, read it please, made ruler over his household to give them food in due season. Watch. He says, the master who is Christ, in his house there are many servants. He will come and take one servant. Come here. And he's a cedar. He says, he will take this man and says, now I put you over this house. Your assignment is to give them food. Any man who wants to eat must relate to him. So the only way they can enjoy help is through here. So the master, now his assignment is to release the food to him, and this man gives to them. Listen to me. Every time you neglect the ministry of a shepherd, you cannot enjoy help from above. Why? The ministry of the shepherd is a divine platform onto which men on the earth can access help from heaven. When you see a man of God, a shepherd coming, understand that Prophet Kevin is not just a man. Prophet Kevin is a system. Prophet Kevin is an altar. Prophet Kevin is a bridge. Prophet Kevin is a gate that you can access help. That is why you can be fasting and praying for something for 10 years and I just move. I put my hand on your head. Now, it was just like this and that was all. Poverty disappeared. And you've been praying, Lord, bless me, Lord, bless me. I just had to come and do this, and it was the end. Why? God has interest to give you help. But let me say this to you. God helps you through your shepherd. God is a God of order, not disorder. There is a system the way God operates. Many of you are helpless because though I am present in your life, you are neglecting my ministry to you. Or if you are not neglecting my ministry, you are taking it for granted. There are some things that should not happen. There are some things I say it can happen. It should not happen to any child here. It should not happen. when it happens, I ask myself, how come? Is this not a child born? How can this happen to you? Do you know what I represent before heaven? Do you know what I stand for? There is a dimension of God that I have been assigned by heaven to bring to men. So some things should not happen to any child here unless he has neglected. The shepherd is your access to help. Bible says in Judges 6 verse 7, he said, and the people cried and God sent them a prophet. Exodus 3 verse 1 to 7, and when the people cried, God sent Moses. God always responds to your prayer for help by sending a shepherd your way. So every encounter with a prophet is not coincidental. It is orchestrated by heaven to facilitate the release of help from above. So you don't play. You see this hand? This hand here. Your money is here. Your marriage is here. This is what I'm going to tell you. Now this is not pride. It's a reality. Your money is in this hand. This hand that is empty up. Your marriage is here. Your children are in this hand. Your visa is here. When this hand comes on your head, it has ability to open the gates for what God kept for you in heaven to manifest in your life. This hand. He said he appointed the servant to give food. Now, food is not just physical food. Food may be marriage. He says he appointed a servant to give food to those in the house in due season. So when your season comes and your shepherd is absent, you'll be hungry. He's the one that will say, ah, Lord, this my daughter has to marry. Friends, I pray that we grow. One secret of the Nigerian church is that they have grown to understand the ministry of their shepherds. It's not because these men are so anointed than us. It is simply because they have people that believe in them despite their weaknesses. So even the little anointing they possess is multiplied by the faith of the people. But in Cameroon, a pastor can walk himself to death and nobody moves his hand because they don't understand what these men and women represent to us. Hear me, dear people of God. Bible says, and David went to the cave of Adullam. He says, and 300 men came to him that were outcasts. 300 outcasts, rebels of a nation, rejected by family, rejected by society. He said, and he transformed them to mighty men. Do you know the power of a shepherd to change a destiny? 300 outcasts, rejected by society, rejected by family, armed robbers, smokers, prostitutes. But they had the wisdom to submit to a shepherd. And when David began to work on them, at the end, he says they were the mighty men. How did they move from being outcasts and rejected people to mighty men? It was the ministry of a shepherd. The Lord said, Peter, follow me. I will make you. Lift your hands and say, Lord, help me to honor my shepherd. This is where help comes from. 300 men outcast, one man. If they had not met David, they would have ended as outcasts. Can you see how important a shepherd is? One man came, 300 men. The Bible said they were outcasts. It means their family threw them away. They are smoking, they are bad. David took them and began to teach them. And the outcasts became mighty men and rulers in the nation of Israel because they met a shepherd. It doesn't matter how your life has been. If you can encounter a shepherd and submit yourself to the discipline of his message, your destiny will be restored. It does not matter how things have gone bad. Whether you... Come on. Mary was a prostitute. When the Lord met her, she changed her life. Don't play with the ministry of a shepherd. That's where help comes from. You can be crying now. You have a problem. I said, this hand that you see, your healing is here. Healing for HIV is here. It's not in heaven. I'm saying this with every form of boldness. It's not in heaven. Healing for cancer, it is in my hand. That is why God called me and anointed me and put, he has put the things here. that me, I should not come and lay. Your child is here. Your job is here. Your favor is here in my hand. In my hand. Your breakthrough is here. So you want to neglect this hand. You will not see help. The reason why Hannah stayed in barrenness is because she was neglecting the ministry of Eli. And now we come to the temple and she will come there and she will pray, Lord, give me a child. And she will finish praying and she will go. One day she came and prayed. And while she was praying, Eli the priest came and said, what is wrong? Are you drunk? She said, I'm not drunk. I need a child. And Eli, Bible says, Eli said, go in peace. May God grant your request. That is 1 Samuel chapter 1 verse 17. Verse 18 says, and the Lord remembered Hannah and she had a child. Why is it that God remembered her only when the shepherd spoke? Because that is where help comes from. You don't play, sir, I want to travel. Go in peace. There is no accident. You know, yet I tell you, there is no demon. There is no power. If you see a man whose destiny is in contention, it means his submission to his shepherd is questionable. When Satan takes Alabatika, there are some things that cannot happen. So I want to travel. Go in peace. On the way, you must see help. If you want to make sure, the only way to secure constant divine help is to submit to the hand of a shepherd. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Now, so since we understand that two things happen when a man lacks a shepherd, what is that? Number one is what? Confusion. Number two is what? Number two. Now, so when God sent the shepherd, therefore, there is a reason why he sent. Don't forget, the only way to secure constant divine help is to submit your head to the hand of a shepherd. The only way. No matter how things get bad, I have two weapons. I have my tongue and my hand. Whether what it happen, tell me. If I'm your shepherd, I can solve it. He appointed the man to give food. I can't be your shepherd and I don't have what it takes to lead you. As long as I'm your shepherd, the thing must be there. Even if I don't have it, that day God will create it for your sake. There cannot be a shepherd that cannot help his people. It can never happen unless he has become greedy and selfish. It can't happen. So when God therefore sends the shepherd, how does he solve the trouble? What are the two problems? Confusion, helplessness. How does he solve it? Number one, when the shepherd comes, God gives his assignment, number one, is to feed you. Is to do what? To feed you with knowledge and understanding. Write it down. To feed you with what? Let us see Jeremiah chapter 3, verse 15 to 16. And I will give you shepherds according to my heart, who will do what? Feed you with knowledge and understanding. Verse 16, see the effect of feeding. Then it shall come to pass when you are multiplied and increased in the land. That's it. Watch here. You see this. He shall feed you. This is the work of a shepherd. To feed you. To feed you with knowledge and understanding. So we see therefore that he that denies to be fed by his shepherd shall never multiply and increase in life. They only multiplied and increased when they gave themselves to the feeding. Friends, on this earth, every message is food. From which table are you eating? It says a man was in his father's house and his father gave him bread to eat. And he said, Father, no, I don't want your bread. Give me money. Let me go. His father gave him money. He went. On the way, money finished. He said he went to a man's house and started eating the food of pigs. If you refuse to be fed on the bread which I give you, you have positioned yourself to eat the food of pigs outside. In AGM, in this place, there is bread. Outside, there is food of pigs. If you deny to accept what I'm teaching and receive it, when hunger will come, you will have no choice but to eat the food of pigs. Because hunger will come. Now watch. This is Luke chapter 15. This one verse 15. He said there was a man that had two sons. The last one said, Father, share your property into two and let me go. He forgot one mistake which I explained ahead. When he went with the money, all the money got finished. Those of you that all you want from pastor is money. You are angry. I have a problem. Pastor has not helped me. He has not given me money. You are not yet wise. You are still immature. You are a baby in Christ. You are still blinded by the things of the flesh. He took money and left his father's house, not knowing that the true responsibility of his father was not to give him money, was to give him bread so that tomorrow he can make money. He went for money. As he left his father's house, Bible says, famine came. When famine came, there was no food to eat. You know what he did? He began to eat the food of pigs. One day, while eating the food of pigs, he said, how many people in my father's house have enough bread to eat? Watch it. Where is their bread? But when he was in his father's house, guess what? He was not seeing the bread there. He was only seen by the money. That's the carnality of people in church. It is when he left, he said, there is something that was in my father's house. There was bread. There was bread. Bread there speaks of the word. Matikoshke. You can rush and go anywhere to receive a miracle. That's very good. Just be careful that after the miracle, you just are eating the food of pigs. In my father's house, there is bread. But while he was there, that's not what he was looking at. He was looking at the money. When he went, he now understood that the strength of fatherhood and a shepherd is the bread he gives you, not the things he gives you. Even if I'll preach as I always do. I'll remove this cloth. I'll dash somebody. It does be very wise. This cloth I give you is not important than what I have taught. But we live in a generation where men are carried by physical things. If I call somebody and say, between me teaching you for 1 hour and me give you 100,000, they will choose 100,000. Because they are unwise. They are carnal. But a spiritual man say, no, daddy, teach me for 1 hour. Because they want to eat. Because the Bible says, it shall feed them with knowledge and understanding, and it shall come to pass that they shall multiply and increase. So we understand that the only pathway to increase and multiplication in the kingdom is feeding from the hand of your shepherd. You must hear what I preach. Your destiny matters a lot on what I'm preaching. When Eve began to eat the fruit of the serpent, she went and disobeyed God. When the serpent, listen, God spoke, it was food. Satan spoke, it was food. When she ate the food of God, it was life. When she ate the food of the serpent, it brought death. What are you listening to? Who are you listening to? Hear me very well. One of the major gateways into your soul and your destiny are your ears. Don't give your ears to any man. And don't be offended. It's not even every gospel channel you watch. There is a confusion now in many of your lives. You listen to 20 men. Don't forget that every man of God has a specific food he carries, and that food is for a specific audience. You have confused yourself. Why is it that people admire what they don't have and despise what they have? People who are here prefer listening to messages of other people outside, and the people who are there, where that man is, your own people want to listen to another side. Because you are not wise. You are not grown. Man of God, teach me. Feed me. Teach me the ways of God. How can I prosper? How can I live in marriage? Teach me. Don't forget that the shepherd has received wisdom from my above to feed. Every true shepherd, he operates beyond his age. What we know is not what we read. It's more than what I read in a book. When I start preaching, wisdom begins to flow from above because I'm a shepherd. I must be equipped. What if you have been married for 80 years? If I start talking about marriage, you think I'm married for 200 years. Because I'm not just speaking from experience. I'm speaking from the wisdom of God that has seen everything and knows everything. Are you with me? The second work of the shepherd is to lead. Is to do what? Show me Exodus 23 verse 16. Is to lead. Somebody say lead. Go to 20. Read. Behold, I send an angel before you to keep you in the way and to bring you into the place which I have prepared. Give me Psalm 23 verse 1. The Lord is my shepherd, shall not want. Verse 2. See the shepherd does. He makes me to lie down in green pasture. He does what? He leads me beside the sea waters. People of God, some people accept to be fed, but they refuse to be led. If I tell you, don't travel to America, you don't start vexed. You don't want to be led. And the sign of true humility is the ability to receive counsel from a shepherd without offense, even when he does not agree with your plan, because he's your shepherd. Don't marry this man. No, he doesn't want me to marry. You don't yet have sense. You are still a baby. You are still a baby. You are still a child. Oh, that's it. They have called me. Because I'm supposed to go to America. Forget about it. Hey, you know, get sense. Man of God won't spoil your life. You are still a child. When you will grow, you will know who is your shepherd. To lead. Direction. Don't forget that they were confused. Now, how will he give you direction if you don't want to listen to what he's saying? Many people accept to be fed, but they refuse to be led. They don't want to be led. They refuse leadership. So, I can preach what I want to preach. I can prophesy. I can lay out on them. But if it comes to say, do this, hey, understand. Don't travel here. No, man of God, I've heard what they say, but I have my plan. Don't travel. Submit yourself. Are you with me, child of God? Leadership. He leads you. But watch. He leads you beside still waters. And he restores your soul. You see, therefore, you cannot enjoy refreshing of the soul if you do not accept the leading of your shepherd. What I can be saying to you to do now can look a type. But at the end, there is refreshing. He leads me beside still waters and he restores my soul. You will not enjoy refreshing of the soul if you do not accept the leading of your shepherd. Do this. There are people that come to church and they have issue with their wife. Do this. They start arguing. I just laugh. I say, go out. God, may God help you people. You are still a child. If there's a case, I say, leave it. Don't talk. Leave it. I know why you don't know. Why? Before God made me your shepherd, he has to give me wisdom. I'm operating in a divine wisdom, not because I merit it, but because my office as a shepherd gave it to me. That's a need of a shepherd, to lead. He leads me beside still waters. He leads me. People of God, how many of you here, I have led you and you rejected my leading? See where you are now. See where you are. Some of you come back after 4 years. Papa, that's what you will tell me. At least I want to know. After 4 years, are you joking with your destiny? Number one, I am a man of prayer. Number two, I hear from God. When I talk to you, it may not make sense now. Stop thinking you know more than your shepherd. That's a spirit of pride. Immediately you know more than your shepherd, please change shepherd and go to one that knows more than you. Because a man you know more than can never lead you. Because anything he says, you will argue. Because it's not in accordance with your own knowledge. That is why you see argument. People, I can be preaching like this. Somebody will say, no, at that point too, if you talk so. They don't want to learn. They want to argue because they are proud. Proud people, you can teach. They would look for one point that does not agree with their sense and claim that they don't want to know. They want to tell you their own point of view. Be quiet and learn. If you can learn, you will earn. Once you know more than your shepherd, change shepherd very fast. Or once you think you know more, change. Because you have already arrived at a dimension where you cannot receive. Number three, the work of the shepherd is to watch over your soul. Show me Hebrews 13 verse 17. Obey those who rule over you and be submissive, for they watch over your soul as those who must give account. Let them do so with joy and not with grief, for that will be unprofitable for you. Hey. It It didn't say that the angel is watching over your soul. It didn't say the Holy Spirit is watching over your soul. It says there is a man watching over your soul. And that man has to give account to God. Do you understand that there are certain things of your life that it is me that give account to God? That God can come and judge me for something that happened to you? Be wise. He watches over your soul. No matter the demonic contention in your destiny, it is the voice of your shepherd that silences the voice of Satan. When the devil comes for you, he said, Peter, while you were sleeping and snoring, there was a meeting in heaven. Satan came. While you were sleeping, the masquerade of your father's family came. He said, but I pray for you. I have watched your soul. You will not die. And you wake up. I was on a bike, and the bike shifted, and the bike man just turned. You don't know that there is a man watching over your soul. You don't know. Listen to me. There is a confidence with which I approach life. You know why? I have a shepherd. Oh, Apostle Johnson Suleiman, my God. I'm not talking about a man somewhere. No, a shepherd who remains and just call me. I mean, the one that you watch on Celebration TV. He will say, he come and say, Kevin, I was praying for you. This is what I saw. Things that we all, my prophet, I need to see and I don't see at all. He will call. On my birthday, we're here. He called. We didn't call. He was just a man and called. That's a shepherd. How are you? I'm fine. How is your wife? Then he prayed, spoke some certain words. Oh, who is watching over your soul? How dare you travel? Your shepherd does not know. Where are you? When demon come on the road, what is your certificate you will show him? But if I said go in peace, which devil can stand? Where did he come from? When the devil stands against you, even though he may be stronger than your dimension, the grace upon your shepherd is what will rebuke him. That this one is under authority. Touch not mine anointed, and do my ambassadors no harm. Sit down. Peter was sleeping. Jesus said, oh, Peter, listen. While you were sleeping, the power from your father's house, the masquerade from your village came. He said, but boy, I have prayed for you. He didn't say, Peter, go and pray. He said, Peter, me, I've already prayed. Hey, thank Lord, thank you for Apostle Suleiman. So I've prayed for you. Apostle Suleiman is not your shepherd. He is my shepherd. He's not your shepherd. You may know him. He does not know you. He is my shepherd. He does not watch over your soul. I, Kevin, I watch over your soul. So if you think that your faithfulness should be somewhere else, then you are not wise. Are you following me? He said, Peter, something happened in the night. Mami Wata came out to take you. He said, but I prayed for you. Everything is okay. And Peter said, when? Peter did not know. Some of you don't know that while you are sleeping, your soul is being invoked in satanic gadgets to kill you, to afflict you, to manipulate your life. Then as they gather, they hear somebody praying somewhere, Father, protect every woman in AGM. And they check you. You are a woman in AGM. They say, leave her. Because somebody was praying. Father, protect every woman in AGM. Protect the men in AGM. Lord, protect the children. They will not have accident. I pray like that every day. They will not have accident. They will be fine. No evil will happen to them. They cannot die by bullet. Every day. So when stray bullet is coming, he knows people that he can touch. Joshua went to war. Alakiba. Bible says, and Moses went to the mountaintop. Bible specifies that when the hands of Moses were lifted, Joshua won the war. He said, but when his hands came down in the war, people began to die. Now I am shocked. Joshua is a skilled soldier, but your victory in warfare does not depend on your skills and strategy. It depends on the position of the hands of your shepherd. No matter how you have wisdom and sense for business, if this boy's hand is down for your sake, your wisdom will be frustrated by Satan. Because you have wisdom. But hear me, your enemies are not empty. To underestimate the ability of your enemy is to apply for untimely death. People who are fighting you, they are not empty. They are empowered by evil spirit. So your wisdom alone is not enough. You need an anointing. Lakish Kabahade. That oppress in the realm of the spirit. Sir, I want to start. You see this door? Listen. I'm on the altar. The Lord Jesus appeared. Appeared in my room. Appeared. I said, build the tower. And showed me the tower in the spirit. He said, build it. Showed me everything. The Lord angel, the Lord Jesus appeared and spoke to me. I woke up. I said, Papa Suleiman, this is what the Lord said. Oh, what do I do? He said, go out and build. It shall be done very fast. Oh boy. 3 months from foundation to roofing. Spent over 20 million foundation to roofing. Wait, it happened. Not one person had a scratch, no one man for nothing. Because even the demons of Kumba that were angry with what I was doing, when they want to come, there is a voice that says, shift. I am not alone, my friend. I am not alone. Don't mind. This is I'm not alone. I went to Nigeria for minister's conference. And it was about 11. You know, stubbornness is a devil. It's a devil. 11 in the night. So Apostle Suman just said, I should come and see him. I came. 11 o'clock. I said, what? He said, just wanted to see me. I said, I'm going now. He said, now? I said, yes. He said, in the night? I said, yes. He looked at me. That looking was saying, I don't go. But you know, stubbornness is a devil. I said, we are going now. He said, now? He said, why not tomorrow? Listen, boy. Fathers do not give suggestion. Take their suggestion like instruction. He said, why not tomorrow? I said, we want to go now. We want to arrive tomorrow first in Cameroon because I gave reason. He said, okay, go. As I was going, around 1 in the night, bam! There are fair trees and blocked the roads. Heavily armed men came out with gun. Not then gun, AK-47. As the drivers stopped and they came out from the bush, driver wanted to reverse. They started shooting. People shouting in the car, blood of Jesus. I was sitting in front and they stood in front. One stood there. And my hands were folded. I was so frightened that I could not talk. Forget saying faith. When the team meet you, I said, when the team meet you, I'm not going to close. I was so frightened. I was like this. Even Jesus not come up here for prophet him up. Because now you are confused what is happening. I was like this. See, before we all realize, as we reverse and went behind, I don't know how it happened. As we're reversing, military was coming. Military entered, followed them in the bush. This is in Nigeria. Shot! And military came back, cleared the road. Guess what? As I arrived, where there was no network, around 3, my phone rang. Who is calling? Apostle Suleiman. He said, where are you? Samuel. He said, at 1, the Lord woke me up to pray for you. Are you all right? I said, rise up and celebrate my father. Celebrate my shepherd, Apostle Johnson Suleiman. Put your hands together. Let's celebrate the grace and the gift of God to me, to my wife. In Jesus' name. Please sit down. He watches over your soul. Hear me. If you are going for a project, don't be afraid. As long as you have told me, nothing can happen to you. No, I mean, even if they fly, it cannot touch you. You see this earth? Earth is controlled by powers. And powers are commanded by men. If they have power, me too, I have power. This is not boasting. It is boldness in my capacity as a prophet. Are you with me, child of God? To watch over your soul. I want to say number 4, and you will not like it. The 4th work of the shepherd is to discipline you. Show me Psalm 23, verse 4. Yeah, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Now, I want to say, your rod and your staff, your rod. Staff. Staff is to guide. Rod is to beat. Hear me very well. I'll never forget this thing. One of the signs that your shepherd's heart has been turned away from you is that he does not discipline you when you do wrong. Hear it. I've been a pastor. I tell you true. When a shepherd still likes you, if you do wrong, he does not talk. Just know that he's not happy. Even if he's talking, be happy if he's talking every day. Don't say, demon, I'm trying to talk. Why say I'm only talk? If they talk for your own, means they like you. A shepherd does not correct those whom he does not love. You just say, it is well. When he loves you, show me Hebrews 12:6. He said, the Lord discipline those whom he loves. For the Lord discipline those he loves, and he discipline and he punishes each one he accepts as his child. So if the Lord does not punish you, in the book of Proverbs, it is written, if a son whom the father does not punish is a son whom the father does not love. But today, the misconception, pride, and bitterness has made people to interpret discipline as hatred. Why have people said that my own talk? Because they like you. Be quiet and hear what they are saying. Some people are more focused on the discipline than on what they did that brought the discipline. This is what happened to Cain. Cain made an error. God came to discipline him. He said, my punishment is too high. You are from killing your brother. All you see is the punishment. This is the power of pride and bitterness. It makes you misinterpret discipline for hatred and wickedness. When pride or bitterness operates in the heart of a sheep, it makes him misinterpret the discipline of his shepherd as wickedness. I don't know. All the ambassador is doing today. Why is that? Is when Antigena Papa is not shouting. He's shouting because he has interest in your life. But we don't know these mysteries. Discipline. Friend, you need a man that will say stand and you stand. No, stand, you beg that this. Some people have issues. Stand, you stand. Sit, you sit. Because you know this is the man. This is the shepherd over your life. He must discipline you. Please, do not neglect the rod. His rod and his staff. If you keep doing things, I'm telling you, and I don't talk, just I'm telling you the secret, just know that my heart has left you. Because if my heart is still with you, you do one, I will say, I will talk. If I talk, I stop talking. No sin about that. All I will do for you is to be praying. That's all I can do. I will not be talking again. Give me Psalm 141 verse 5. He said, let the righteous man slap me, it shall be oil for my head. Let the godly strike me, it will be kindness. If they correct me, it is a soothing medicine. Don't let me refuse it. Let the godly strike me, it shall be kindness. If they correct me, it shall be a soothing medicine. Another verse says, let the godly slap me, it shall be anointing for my head. So one of the ways to increase in the anointing of God upon your life is to submit to the discipline of your shepherd. The more he disciplines you, the more he refines you and reshapes you to be best and better in life. How have you even a small boy talk for when I saw? That is the word of people who are not wise. It's not by age, it's by position. You are calling me small boy. But when you travel on the road, smaller boys than me say, stand and you stand. Put your hand up, you put it up. You don't argue them. Now me, you argue them. Because me, I don't carry guns, so I don't get what. I lie. Smaller boys than me, stand. You call them shape, grand. Repe. Stand here. Yes. Adika. Yes, sir. But me now, nobody can control me. Now, for me now, you get power. The faith walk of your shepherd is to release blessings on your head. You prepare table before me. You anoint my head with oil. You do what? Who anoints? There is no way you can take oil and put it on your head. I anoint myself. Somebody must anoint you as your shepherd. Show me number 6:22. And the Lord spoke to Moses saying, verse 23. Speak to Aaron and his son. This is the way you shall bless the children of Israel. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. See verse 27. So they shall put my name on the children of Israel and I will bless them. Are you seeing what the shepherd does? Every time he speaks word on you, he put God's name on you. That is why, as I say, this month you are blessed, you are favored. I stamp their favor. As you move, demons of bad luck see you. They say, we cannot touch this one. He has a seal on his head. He has a stamp. I want to tell you something. This mouth and this hand, don't play with these two things. Don't play. There is a blessing. That is why we even bless, it does not work. It's because you don't have understanding of faith. Let me say this to you, and this is not pride. All of you can suffer and die till you enjoy the thing that I've carried from God. Even if you don't like for the day for the church, no, I don't get a problem. Go for another church. I'm going to say no. For say me alive, they fine. You must be under some man of God. That's the truth. There must be one man whom blesses you. But this is the problem. Notice, I brought discipline before blessing. Because a man who cannot discipline you, his blessings cannot operate on your head. Even if he say it, I mean, if a talk stays spit, cover your head like shower. Nothing will enter. Discipline. Confess before blessing. The blessing. I bless myself. No. He said, with that contradiction, the lesser is blessed by the greater. There must be a man to bless you. How? What is your responsibility towards your shepherd? Eh? I'll do this first. Number one is to follow him. Is to do what? Show me Luke chapter 5 verse 8, please. Let's do. When Simon saw it, he fell down at Jesus' feet. Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. Verse 9. For he and all who were with him were astonished at the catch of fish which they had taken. 10. Okay, and Jesus said to Simon, do not be afraid. From now on, you will catch men. Another version says, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. Follow me, I will make you. Follow me, I will do what? He didn't say, follow me, I will give you fish. See that? Not follow me, I will give you fish. I will make you. You see, as I'm teaching now, you see all these people gather here. I am making them. Follow me. I will make you. Who you follow determines what you become in life. That is why I always do my best to walk with the Lord. To stand in holiness. You know why? For the sake of your destiny, I cannot afford to become immoral. What will I make you there for? Follow me, I will make you. Matthew 4:19. Thank you. Bring it up. Then he said to them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. Can I tell you something? Your destiny was ordained by God, but the responsibility of making you it is upon a shepherd. It means God says, my child, you'll be a president. My child, you'll be a prophet. My child, you'll be a doctor. My child, you'll be a billionaire. Now, when God has put that destiny, God now comes to a shepherd and gives him the wisdom and the anointing to make you. He says, now you, follow me. Waka as I waka. Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. That's why my life must always be a reflection of the glory that you desire from God. Are you following me? Do you hear me? Follow me. You have not made a mistake to worship here. No. Every time you come here, you always see 1 month, something comes new. I'm doing all these things to show you that we are moving somewhere. If you follow a historian, you are finished. You must follow a visionary. Not a man who speaks of I was doing. A man who said, this is what we are going to. Those that follow historians end up stagnated. Those that follow visionaries end up in fulfillment. Don't follow people of I was doing. No. A visionary says, next year, we'll do this. We are going here. A visionary. Follow me, I will make you. Do you want to be what God says you should be? Answer me. What is the solution? So I may not be a president. But I have the anointing to make you a president. Paul said we are poor, yet making many rich. But only those who follow us can we make rich. So though I can be poor, I may not have a jet, but it's a prophecy. There are people here that will have jets. In some time to come, when you can 100 billionaires in Cameroon, 20 will be from AGM. Follow me. Number two, responsibility to your shepherd is to honor him. Somebody say honor. Show me 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 12 and 13, please. And we urge you, therefore, to recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord and admonish you. Verse 13. And to esteem them very highly. Esteem them how? Why? For their work's sake. He said, because of what I'm doing for your life, hold me very high. You know, stupid people will say, hey, why is your pastor picture everywhere? Are you worshiping your pastor? Tell them, I am, God said, hold him high esteem. It means among everyone you esteem, he said, your pastor must be the highest one you esteem. Why? Because of the work he's doing for your soul. Please give me anything. Dear brothers and sisters, honor those who are your leaders in the Lord's work. They work hard. Oh, greet everybody. Dear brothers and sisters, honor those who are your leaders in the Lord's work. They work hard among you and give you spiritual guidance. Verse 3. Show them what? Small or great? Great respect and wholehearted love because of their work. Do you know there are some people that don't greet pastor's wife? They are still babies. They never grow. They don't understand what the pastor's wife represents to their life. There are people who see their pastor and you're making faces with a man that has this, your destiny. You are making girls with your pastor. You got angry, you see your pastor, you don't want to greet him. Are you really that ignorant? Come on, be mature. Push away that offense. This man is my shepherd. See your pastor, make us be busy, you bend your head. You're a shepherd. You are playing games. Your destiny is truncated. He said, respect them. Great, not small, great respect. He said, Jesus went to his hometown and could not do miracles. Why? Not because the anointing was absent. They did not honor him. A prophet is not without honor. You see this man? He's older than me. Eh? But if I come, he stands up. It's not worship, it's respect. If I want to pray, he will kneel down. It's not worship, it's honor. You must learn the law of honor. Honor, honor. When you meet man of God, don't stretch your hand. If you treat him as a friend, you receive not from him. He that receives a prophet, not as his brother-in-law or his brother, but as a prophet. Don't stretch your hand. When you go to your chief, you don't stretch your hand. Yes, oh, I'm lying. Yes, is prophet you want to stretch your hand? Because you don't know what it represents. I'm teaching you love. If you see the man of God passing, stand up. Even if it's in your store, stand up. When you honor a man, you provoke heaven to honor you. When you dishonor whom God has honored, you make yourself an enemy to heaven and heaven will resist you. Show honor. Kneeling down is not worship. No. If it was worship, those who kneel down to propose to women, are they worshiping the women? Why not for church when I want to talk? It's honor. Have honor. He says, not, let's say it again, what kind of respect? Great respect. Great. Great respect. Not small one. Great respect. Can I give you that energy again? Great respect. Dear brothers and sisters, honor those who are your leaders in the Lord's work. They work hard among you. They do what? They work hard among you and give you spiritual guidance. Honor them. Yeah. Show them great respect. And which kind of love? Partial love. Wholehearted love because of their work. When you know that this shepherd is the one praying for me, feeding me, leading me, you don't have time to say, I'm glad. Now, Chris, can I tell you something? If you love anger more than your destiny, you will fail in life. Sometimes when you get angry, you should know that you don't get angry with any person. There are people, No matter the anger, tell the anger that anger, no, you cannot come for this man, not this one. Because you know the, come on. Who here can get angry and just take 20 million and throw it in water? At the vex! Yeah, money. Why does their anger not make them? It shows the value they have for their pastor. They vex and they can't church. He goes to his job site. They insult him. They ridicule him. He still comes to job. He keep coming. At their office, they will insult him. Ridicule him. Gossip against him. He still come. Now, any good church they gossip about a person. Now, church where gossiping is that. But he's still working. Is he not still working there? Is he not still working? But if it's church, because they don't know the value of church and the man of God. So they like, I need to go to that church again. What happened? I don't know the way pastor talk. Are you conscious of your pastor? Are you conscious of your destiny? This shows that people are still babies and they are ignorant. God cannot bring you to a man that has what it takes to make you successful. And one day he's preaching, and in the preaching, let's say he makes an error and says something which is not good. And for you, that is enough reason. I don't vex. Man, ask you a question. Vex keep by waiting. Listen, langa man de fear pepe. You see that talk? Langa man no de fear pepe. You go chop up. When you not where you want them, no fear pepe. I say langa man no de fear. Look never say neighbor. Langa man no de fear pepe. Number three, the third thing you must do for your shepherd is to obey him. Someone say obey. Please show me Hebrews 13 verse 17. Obey your spiritual leaders and do what they say. Their work is to watch over your soul, and they are accountable to God. Give them reason to do this with joy and not with sorrow. That will certainly not be for your benefit. I hope you are listening to second service message last week. Paul say, I pray for you because your obedience have refreshed me. When a son is disobedient, he gives pressure to his father. When a son is obedient, he gives pleasure to his father. Oh, obedience. If I say stand. Forget say you know. Stand. Let us fast tomorrow. Yes, sir. Let us come to church in the evening. Yes, sir. You obedience. Oh my God. Sir, I have some money. I want to do this business. Don't do it. I must not give you reason. Yes, sir. Sir, please, what can I do now? Do this one. Yes, sir. When God sees that kind of heart, God blesses you. He blesses you automatically. Obedience. You can't be disobeying the instruction of a man that knows the way to your success. How you go reach for that? Oh, wait. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not lack. Watch. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. If he's leading you, say, no, I need to go now. So, I won't go me now. So, will you arrive the still waters? Obedience. Number four, lastly, you must give to your shepherd. Show me Ezekiel 44, verse 30. The best of all first fruit. Can we read? Read now. The best of all first fruit of any kind, and every sacrifice of any kind from all your sacrifices shall be the priest. You also, you shall give to the priest the first of your ground meal. To do what? To cause a blessing to rest on your house. Give me NLT. You must give. The first of the ripe fruits, the ripe one. Not yeah, ripe, not unripe. Anybody who give me unripe pineapple again in this church? Or ripe mango. Papa, this is for you. The first of the ripe fruits and all the gifts brought to the Lord. We'll do what? We here. Pastor, they chop church money. Wait, you got over there. Much on a church, right? Read them for there. How this man of God eating church money? Yeah, God said we should chop. Read it. Can thou read? What readest thou? The first of the ripe fruits and all the gifts brought to the Lord will go to the priest. the first sample of each grain harvest and the first of your flour must also be given to the priest, so the Lord will bless your home. Not so the Lord will bless you, he will bless your home. Not you, your home. There is a giving you give me, and it comes, and it touches even your husband who is not coming to church, because anything that has to do with your home, give to your priest. If I say, let's come up with 10,000, that one is good. But the greatest giving is the one you remember and say, sir, you just remember that willing. I say, I want to give. That is the one that brings blessing. More than the one that we announce. Are you following me here? Give. Give substance. Give gifts. Give what you can give. Anybody having a business, your shepherd must have a portion. If you are selling rice, as you buy rice, says, this is one is for you. If you have this kind of mindset, you can never ever be shunned. He said, you will cause the blessing to rest on your home. So the greatest way to continually operate in the blessing is to continually be giving to your shepherd. When you give to your shepherd, don't say, hey, now my last money. No, you are giving. You are giving. Mommy, tomorrow. Hey, my last money is. You are giving to a man that has the anointing to that will multiply. Get it. Let us give 20,000. Mommy, next year I will give. I'm never giving today. Now my last money. He said, give. What will happen to your house? Man of God, in my house now, my children are not passing exam. What is it? Because there is a curse on your house. Curses bring failure and barrenness and death. My children are always sick. Many of you have curses on your house. Children always sick. Every day you are fighting with your wife. He says, when you give to the priest, a blessing will not come on you. Something will cover your house. There is success. There is life. There is peace. There is joy. There is righteousness. There is increase. Why? Because that is why you, if your family members don't have the wisdom, you have the wisdom. When you are coming to see the man of God over your life, in your heart, Father, you know that my uncle abroad is suffering. Because he's part of my house, as I give this thing, let it touch him. I'm teaching you how to now operate with the man of God. Listen to me. Even if you come and give me 50 million, never ever think you are giving it to help me. If you have that kind of giving to man of God, is not a donation. Never ever give to man of God as donation. Give to man of God as is a seed you are sowing for a harvest to come in your life. He says, when you give, God will reward you with the blessing. Are you following me, child of God? So give monthly, weekly. When you want to come to the man of God, bring something to give. Give. Even if you think that he has more than you, give. He said, he that has much more shall be given. No, the Bible talks so. Give. Because it is a law for the blessing to come. With that, I say great grace. Rise on your feet.